Hey everyone, welcome to our first proper tutorial in this Learn Tinker course. In this introductory video, I just want to show you how we can create simple buttons in Tinker. Buttons are a huge part of any GUI that we are going to be building, and just about any GUI you will build or use has some use for a button. So let's get right into this. Anytime we want to use Tinker, we must import Tinker to our Python project. I have a video on how to import Tinker to your Python project, and I'll leave a link in the description below if you're wondering how to do that. So, once we have installed, we can just import Tinker like so. Then we need to open our main Tinker window. This is basically our main GUI window, which we will do by giving it a name. So, let's just call ours main. So this is our main root window, and TK with open parentheses. Then, since GUIs are just a continually looping function, we need to tell Python that we want to loop our function, or loop our GUI. Therefore, let's move down a couple lines and tell Python to continually loop our function by stating that we want our main window, that is our main root window, to be a main loop, like so. Now, when we run our Python file, you can see that we do indeed get a working window, but it just doesn't really do anything at this point. Therefore, we need to add a button to it. So, to create a simple button widget in Tinker, we need to first give it a variable name. So, let's just call this button1. Then we need to give it a value. To create a button widget, we use the button function. So we type button, and then as you can see in the parentheses, it tells us the parameters that we need to give arguments for. So we need to tell it the master, or what window will this button be placed in. And we want it in our main window, so let's just type main. Then we have a few options here. We can enter some text, so let's just say we want our button to say click me. Well, then we just tell it we want it to have some text equals click me. We'll come back to a few of the options here in a minute, but for now, let's just verify that our simple button is going to work. So, as I explained in the last video, the Tinker Fundamentals video, we must first create our widget, which we just did, but that just creates the information about our button. We need to actually tell Python to place that information into our main GUI. To do this, we need to either pack or place this widget in a Tinker grid. If you missed our last video, I talked about the two main methods for creating and arranging your created widgets in Tinker. So if you missed that video, please check that out as well, and I will leave a link in the description below for you to do so. So let's just pack the button because it's easier. So we type our variable name for our button, and then use the pack method to stuff our button into our GUI. Now, when we run our program, we receive this little button back to us, which is pretty cool. But as you can see, when we click the button, nothing really happens. Well, what else do you think we can do with our buttons to make it more useful? Well, what if we wanted to change the color of the button, or the text in the button? Well, remember back to earlier when I mentioned we had some options in the button function. This is what I was referring to. We can go back to our button definition, and after the text, we can enter FG for foreground, which changes the text color, and BG for background, if you're on Windows, and this will change the background color. However, if you're on a Mac, you have to use highlight background to change the background color, as BG doesn't really seem to work. Then, for either of these, we can choose really any color you want. For example, let's make a black background and gold text. We just need to enter these colors as strings like so. You could also enter a hex number, which is a 6-number code that corresponds to a given color. Either way works. So, now that we know how to create buttons, add them to our GUI, color them, what if we wanted to make our button actually do something? Well, we can add a line here that says command, and then link that to a Python function. So, let's create a simple Python function that tells us when our button is clicked. To do so, let's name our function buttonClicked. Then we need to create a label, which is just a text widget in Tinker. Then we just need to pack this label into our main GUI widget. But before we run this, we need to tell Python that we want our button to use this function when we click the button. To do so, we enter the command here in our button options, and type our function's name. Now, when we run the program, every time we hit this button, it'll activate the linked Python function. This is why every time when I hit this button here, we receive this line of text. Now, the functions that are associated with a button can be quite a bit more complex than this one that I showed here. However, the principle on how we link the function to the button is the same. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how we can use and customize buttons within Tkinter. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.